You've heard that you get 50% of your DNA from each parent and 25% from each grandparent, 12.5% from each great-grandparent, and on and on and on. But is that really true? Howdy, I'm Andy Lee with Families Fanatics, where we help you understand your DNA, climb your family tree, and write your ancestor stories along the way. Today we're talking about where we get our DNA. Now let's begin by understanding what DNA we're talking about. Today, we're just talking about autosomal DNA. Now, autosomal DNA is the 22 pairs of chromosomes that you have that does not include your mitochondrial DNA, and it also does not include X or Y. That's the 23rd pair of chromosomes that you have. So we're just talking about the first 22 pairs of chromosomes. Now, since there are 22 pairs of chromosomes, that means there are 44 total chromosomes that we're concerned with today. So when it comes to our parents' DNA, what do we get from each one of our parents? Well, this is actually a really easy question to answer. We get one set of chromosomes from each parent, and that means we get 22 chromosomes from each parent. So in order to do the math, you just have 22 divided by 44. That equals 50%. When we're talking about autosomal DNA, you always get 50% of your DNA from each of your two biological parents. Simple as that. So if we get 50% of DNA from each one of our parents, always, do we get 25% of DNA from each one of our grandparents? Because our parents had two parents as well. Now that would make logical sense, and if you just do the math, that's usually how it is presented. But that's not always the case. In fact, that's mostly not the case. Now you guys are all right. Each one of our parents also has 22 pairs of chromosomes. And each of these pairs comes from either our grandfather, their father, or our grandmother, their mother. So in one pair, they have a grandfather chromosome and they have a grandmother chromosome. Now that's talking about us. It would be their mother and their father. But for us, it would be a grandfather chromosome and a grandmother chromosome that our parents have. This next part is really important to understand. Before either one of your parents pass on a set of chromosomes to you, the chromosome, in other words, the pair that they have, goes through a process called recombination. During that process, that pair of chromosomes, one from the grandfather, one from the grandmother, they may swap different locations so that the chromosome that's passed on to you is not necessarily from the grandmother or the grandfather, but it is actually a combination of the grandmother and the grandfather chromosomes that your parents have. Let me say that again. Each chromosome that you have, let's say for instance, the chromosome number one that you got from your father, that chromosome is a mixture of the chromosome one that your father's father, your grandfather, and your father's mother, your grandmother, combined together into a new chromosome, which is what you receive. So because of this, there are several different ways that you can inherit DNA from your grandparents. And this is on an individual chromosome level, and it differs not just for each individual chromosome, but also each person. Let's go through the possibilities. The first possibility is you get a chromosome that is 100% from your grandfather. In other words, your father passes on his paternal chromosome complete to you. Now let me show you what that looks like. If I'm going to GEDmatch and I compare myself to my paternal grandfather, you can see here on chromosome number 6, that it is all blue along the bottom, indicating that it is a half match all the way across. In other words, my chromosome number 6 from my father is the exact same as the chromosome that he inherited from his grandfather. That's pretty cool. Likewise, the same thing can happen with your grandmother. You can inherit a chromosome that your parent received from their mother exactly the way that your parent has it. If I look at myself again, and this is comparing to my grandfather, I look at chromosome number 22 and I see that it is black across the bottom. That indicates that there is no match for my grandfather, which means I inherited this chromosome from my grandmother, from my paternal grandmother. So it is an exact copy of the chromosome that my father has, which he received from his mother. Now we also can receive a chromosome that is mostly from our grandfather. What might this look like? Well, here is my chromosome number 11, and you can see that the majority of it is blue, indicating a half match. That matches me and my grandfather. But then there is on the end a little tail portion that is black, indicating that it is not a match to my grandfather, so it is a match to my grandmother. And so this chromosome, chromosome number 11, is mostly from my grandfather, but some of it is from my grandmother. Now we can go the flip way and you can receive chromosomes that are mostly from your grandmother. If I look at chromosome number 7, it is black almost the entire length until right at the very end there is a little tiny bit of blue indicating a half match. And that little half match I match with my grandfather, but this chromosome is mostly the chromosome of my grandmother. And finally, you can have a chromosome that's about equally matched from both grandparents. So in other words, during that recombination process, it put bits of each one together to make it about 50-50. What does that look like? Well, here's my chromosome number 1. You can see there are two segments that are blue and there are two segments that are black. The blue segments are the ones that I received from my grandfather, and the black segments are the ones that I received from my grandmother. Now they're varying lengths, but overall it's about 50% from my grandfather and 50% from my grandmother. One of the important things to remember is this is a random process. So you are not going to be able to predict which one it is until you actually compare yourself with your grandparents. Now, if I take my full set of chromosomes and I compare it to both my paternal grandfather and my paternal grandmother, I got 25% from my paternal grandfather and 25% from my paternal grandmother. Now, I said at the beginning that it's not always the case, but this looks like it's perfect. I got 50% from my parents. I got 25% from each one of my grandparents. Yeah, but see, I'm sort of the exception because if I look at my brothers here, you can see that, well, some of them are 27%, looks like down to 22%, 23, 24, 25, 26. They're all around 25%, but none of them actually got 25% from either one of our paternal grandparents. These are the same paternal grandparents. And so what you need to understand is there is actually a range of DNA that you could inherit from your grandparents. Just like you saw with me and my brothers, I inherited 25% from each one, so I inherited equal amounts, but my three brothers did not inherit equal amounts. In fact, all three of them inherited a little bit more DNA from our grandfather than we did from our grandmother. So where is this range of DNA? It's about between 20% and 30%. So you should expect to see numbers that are in this range. Now there's some extreme cases that may go below this or may go above this, but those are actually pretty rare. For the vast majority of people, if you compare your DNA with any of your grandparents, you'll find that you share about 20 to 30% of your total DNA with them. The last important thing to remember is that if you receive 30% from your paternal grandfather, you must receive 20% from your paternal grandmother. Why is that? Because their DNA is what makes up your father's DNA. and you received 50% of your DNA from your father. So their DNA has to add up to 50%. So 30%, you get 20%. If you have 25%, you're going to get 25%. That is how it works. So we always receive 50% of our DNA, half of our DNA from each one of our parents. But once we get to our grandparents and our great-grandparents, recombination makes it so that we don't always share the exact average. It will be around that average. For our grandparents, it's 25%. For our great-grandparents, it's 12.5%. But it's not necessarily going to be that exact amount. Now, if you would like to learn some more about how relationships work with DNA, then check out one of these two videos right here. And if you haven't subscribed to our channel, then be sure to subscribe and click on the bell so you can be notified about upcoming episodes.